When former Lebanese Prime Minister Rafic Hariri was assassinated in Beirut in 2005, his death rocked Lebanon and sparked international outrage. Now, four suspects have been indicted over his murder, and a top Australian cop, Nick Keldis, seconded from the New South Wales police force to investigate the case, has become embroiled in controversy. As Yarrabu Mellon reports, his push for justice in the Hariri killing is causing waves that threaten to overrun Lebanon.
This memorial to Rafic Hariri stands in the centre of Beirut. A constant reminder of his devastating assassination and Lebanon's obligation to find his killers. The country has poured millions of dollars into the international investigation. And for those who believe the bulk of the work has been done by local officers, Nick Keldis is a symbol of money wasted.
هذا الرجل بنى عمله على دماء الشباب اللبنانيين وعرقهم على دماء الضباط اللبنانيين وعرقهم لم يفعل شيئا ذي قيمة ها هي خلاصة.
And this is the man Keldis readily acknowledges played a vital role in cracking the case, a young Lebanese officer named Wissam Eid. Aid began analysing phone records before and after the Hariri assassination. He found what the tribunal calls the Red Assassination Network and the Green Network involved in coordinating the hit. The phone networks led investigators to the alleged killers.
And that's what you look for, people who may have been activated or phones that may have been activated in contact with each other in the lead up to the assassination. Perhaps at the time of the assassination and then immediately afterwards. And that shows a pattern of a coordination, a level of coordination between those phones.
The UN investigation had been criticised for largely ignoring Aid's work, even losing his report. But Keldis says he seized on it.
Absolutely indispensable in taking the work forward. I think Wissam Eid was someone, and I didn't get to meet him, I don't know him, but from everything I've heard, he was someone who knew what was right and what was wrong, and he knew that even though there was a real danger to himself and to those around him, he still proceeded because he felt that was the right thing to do.
In January 2008, Wissam Eid suffered the same fate as Rafic Hariri, blown to pieces by a car bomb.
But I think Wissam Eid himself was a hero.
Hero to the tribunal and martyr to his community. Wissam Eid is celebrated in his hometown near Tripoli in northern Lebanon.
بعد اغتيال ابنك شو حسيته؟
عم تقولي اغتيال وابني شو بدي حس؟ حسرات وقهر وعذاب راحت فقد ابني
شو بدي فكر حرموني منه شو بدي فكر يعني الله يرحمه بدل ما يكفي حياته اساب اول عمره بدل ما زوجه وافرح فيه دفنوا لي اياه حتى ما شفته يعني لما رد ما في مجال تشوفيه لانه ما مخليه منه شيء.
Make no mistake, those who committed the assassination of Wissam Eid did so to send a message to the tribunal, or the commission as it was, and that is to back off and stop the investigation.
Wissam Eid's death became a symbol of Lebanon's so-called culture of impunity. Killers could seemingly strike at will. The nation mourned his death, and the tribunal drew an even tighter cloak around his work. Or so they thought. This is Wissam Eid's office, where much of his groundbreaking work was done. But this inner sanctum has been breached many times, his work comprehensively leaked to Hezbollah and Beirut journalists, including Hassan Ilao from the Al-Akhbar newspaper.
One witness that the tribunal will rely on.
You also have information about the witnesses.
He showed me a number of documents from Lebanese intelligence relating to the Hariri investigation, including this, handwritten by Wissam Eid in January 2006. It includes the mobile phone numbers of the accused. Hassan Ila also has numerous files relating to other high-profile killings linked to the Hariri murders.
Has the case been compromised?
It's unfortunate that perhaps some previous staff members or someone with a grievance has sought to leak some aspect of the investigation. That it's human nature, and that happens. It's disappointing, but the bottom line is I don't think it's had an impact on the investigation or the integrity of the investigation. The evidence is what it is.
Is there some sort of protection afforded to witnesses at the
moment? There is protection available, and I'm certain that the prosecutor in particular and the office of the prosecutor would do everything they can to protect witnesses.
Not only has the information been leaked, Hezbollah is mounting a full-scale counterattack. At this Hezbollah press conference, telecommunication experts dismissed the tribunal's evidence of phone networks allegedly used in the Hariri killing.
يعني وقت بتاخد رقم المشترك بصير انت عم تتصرف عنه فيك تتصل منه فيك تخلق له خدمات جديده تقمص شخصيه المشتركين سو كل هالشيء بيؤدي انه انا بقدر اتقمص شخصيه حدا تاني واشتغل عنه أزف انا هو الشخص التاني اللي هي بسموها بالاي تي بالسايبر كرايم ايدنتيتي ثيفت.
According to Hezbollah, Israel has compromised the Lebanese phone system.
إن اختراق العدو لقطاع الاتصالات أفقد داتا الاتصالات قيمتها الثبوتية.
But Nick Caldas doesn't accept the tampering theory.
No, I don't. The place to have that discussion and any allegations or answers in relation to anything being manipulated is the courtroom. A properly constructed trial with evidence being given and witnesses testifying and being cross-examined. It's easy to stand up on a podium and make really spurious, unprovable allegations when you're not being cross-examined on them. It's very easy to throw out these scurrilous allegations, and I think it's cowardly in many ways.
With Hezbollah determined to never hand over the accused, it seems the Hariri case is moving towards a trial in absentia.
What does Hezbollah have to be afraid of?
The truth. That's basically it. The only thing that you can say Hezbollah and Mr. Nasrallah, and the only reason they're attacking the investigation as they are at the moment, is because they do not want the truth to come out.
6 years after the carnage of the Hariri assassination, much has changed in Lebanon and the Middle East. Hezbollah is stronger than ever, and if the Lebanese have grown weary of this drawn-out hunt for Hariri's killers, Nick Caldas is urging them to stay the course.
I think that the Lebanese people, the international community, have a responsibility, an obligation, to support the tribunal and the trial going ahead. It is justice in its absolute form. It is the only fair process that can be undertaken once people have been indicted for a murder as grave as that of Mr. Hariri. And I think to back away from that effort now will undo a whole lot of people's work, and people like Wissam Eid will have died in vain.
This sign says the truth for the sake of Lebanon. But that truth may be too tightly bound in the complex politics of the region to ever be revealed.